My dear, to see you. May I molest your state? May I sign you?
Bradshaw, Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Are we slowing down for the German border?
Yeah.
Taking this trip.
That
ain't funny. No. Not exactly. I'm a writer. And I get English lessons. Care for a cigarette? Brown,
yeah.
A cigarette?
No, thank you.
Got your bench controller in a passenger. Fraulein Schneider.
See? You are having a new friend, Emma Ludwig. You are having a fine place to stay, and you are perhaps even having your first English pupil. So welcome to Berlin, my friend. Welcome to Berlin.
Welcome to Berlin! Willkommen, bienvenue, welcome. Fremde, étranger, stranger. Je suis enchanté. Happy to see you. Bleib, rest, stay.
Don't you have anything cheaper?
But for a friend of Frau Ludwig.
I have very little money.
But you would give English lessons, and you would have many pupils, and they would pay you, and then you would pay me, yeah?
50 marks. That's my absolute limit. If you've anything else, I don't care how small or how far from the bathroom.
But for a professor, this is more suitable.
I'm not a professor. Think of me as a starving author. What do you have for a starving author?
An author, a poet. You have the look.
A novelist.
A novelist. And you would be most famous. It would be like years ago when in all my rooms, persons of real quality. This is your room. Here is for you to write. And look, your window. You can see the whole of the Nollendorf Platz, and there that little house, the U-Bahn station. What you call the metro, yeah? 10 minutes, you are anywhere in Berlin.
Somewhere.
Such a desirable window for a novelist.
I can still only afford 50 marks.
But this room is worth 100. More than 100, actually. 50. Sit. You say 50 marks, I say 100 marks. A difference of 50 marks. Why should that stand in our way? Huh? As long as the room's to let, the 50 that I would like is 50 more than I had yesterday, yeah? When you're as old as I, anyone as old as I, what difference does it make? An offer comes, you take. For the sun will rise, the moon will set, and you learn how to settle for what you get. It will all go on if we're here or not, so who cares? So what? So who cares? So what? When I was a girl, my summers were spent by the sea. So what? And I had a maid doing all of the housework, not me. So what? Now I scrub up the floors, and I wash down the walls, and I empty the chamber pot. If it ended that way, then it ended that way, and I shrug and I say, so what? For the sun will rise, the moon will set, and you learn how to settle for what you get. It will all go on if we're here or not, so who cares? So what? So who cares? So what? When I had a man, my figure was dumpy and fat. So what? Through all of my years, he was so disappointed in that. So what? Now I have what he missed, and my figure is trim, but he lies in a churchyard plot. If it wasn't to be that he ever would see the uncursed in me, so what? For the sun will rise, the moon will set. Learn how to settle for what you get. It will all go on if we're here or not, so who cares? So what? So who cares? So what? So once I was rich, and now all my fortune is gone. So what? And love disappeared, and only the memory lives on. So what? If I'd lived through all that, and I'd lived through all that, 50 marks doesn't mean a lot. If I like that you're here, and I like that you're here, Happy New Year, my dear, and so what? For the sun will rise, the moon will set, you'll learn how to settle for what you get. It will all go on if we're here or not, so yet. So what? So who cares? It all goes on. So who cares? Who cares? Who cares? So what?
The telephone is in the hall. I will fetch the towels.
Fräulein Schneider, there is no hot water in the bathroom. The second time this week.
Excuse me, Herr Bradshaw.
Oh, you are finally in this room.
Yes, this is Herr Clifford Bradshaw, the world's famous American novelist.
How do you do?
A Fräulein Kost. Across the hall, please. Please, feel free. At any time.
Missy, where are you?
Oh, my nephew, is visiting me from Herr. Come, we talk outside and take your nephew with you. My apologies, Herr Bradshaw. In future, I will be on this way.
Please, don't.
Are governess interested in such persons?
Oh, yes.
What is it now? Oh, Herr Schultz, 11 o'clock already. I'm just showing Herr Bradshaw his room. Herr Bradshaw, Herr Schultz, also lives here.
Pleased to meet you.
You're an American. I have a cousin in Buffalo. Being in Cannonball, do you possibly know him?
I hardly ever get to Buffalo.
Herr Schultz is proprietor of the finest fruit market on the world. I will trust now. Herr Schultz has been kind enough to invite me to join him in their glass of schnapps for the new year. And after all, why not? Otherwise, I'm in bed with a hot water. Perhaps a Bradshaw.
No. Thank you, though.
And I want to wish him a puzzle for the new year.
A puzzle?
Yes. It's me to buy.
Same to you.
I come to Fraulein in 10 minutes. With the schnapps. And the fruit. And now, please, anything you require, not one by joy in my day or night. Also, welcome to Berlin.
Welcome to Berlin!
Welcome to Berlin, famous novelist. Open the Remington.
Hello.
That's what you came here for.
So are you standing all alone like that? Happened to catch my eye.
A drink. You'd like to buy it? Boy, a drink. Welcome to Berlin, famous novelist.
Yeah, you would.
A most talented young lady from England. Yes, England. She is so talented, so charming, so... Yeah? Just last night I said to her, I want you for my wife. And she said, your wife, what would she want with me? Thank you. And now, presenting the toast of Mayfair, Fräulein Sally Bowles!
Thinks I'm living in a convent. A secluded little convent. In the southern part of France. Mama doesn't even have an inkling. And I'm working in a nightclub. In a pair of lacy pants. So please, sir, if you run into my mama, don't reveal my indiscretion. Give a working girl a chance. Hush up, don't tell mama, shush up. Don't tell mama, whatever you do. If you had a secret, you bet I would keep it. I would never tell on you. I'm breaking every promise that I gave her. So won't you kindly do again a great big favor? And please, my sweet potato, keep this from the maid. Though my dance is not against the law. alright, cause he comes in here every night. But don't tell Mama what you saw.
Mama, it's one for Fiora, where they call the night school chums and a lady chaperone.
Yesterday she joined the line.
But don't tell Mama what you know.
You can tell my brother that ain't green, cause if he squeals on me, I'll squeal on him.
So don't tell Mama, Mr. Don't tell Mama, Mr. Don't tell Mama what you know.
If you see my mommy, mom's the word.
Sally Bowes, ladies and gentlemen!
Hello.
You're English!
Absolutely!
Oh, you're American, but you speak English beautifully, darling. I'm over here.
Oh, hello.
Hello. Now you just keep talking, please. You can't imagine how starved I've been.
Okay. Let's see. Somewhere in this favored land, the sun is shining bright. A band is playing somewhere, and somewhere hearts are light. Somewhere men are laughing, and somewhere children shout. But there is no joy in Mudville. Mighty Casey has struck out.
Oh, yes. Don't stop, please.
I'm afraid that's all I know. My name is Clifford Bradshaw.
Where are you from?
Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. You've probably never heard of it.
Do you like my number?
Oh, yes.
Are you alone?
Yes.
Can everybody your drink? But not right at this moment.
Is this Cliff Bradshaw?
Who's this?
Bobby. We met in London at the Nightingale Bar.
Oh, Bobby! Oh, hello!
Listen, it's crazy out here tonight, but how about we meet backstage? It's right here. Later, 15 minutes. Alright?
Alright.
And now, meine Damen und Herren, Mesdames et Messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, it is almost midnight. Husbands, you have only 10 seconds in which to loose your wives. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Have to do it!
Heart owner.
And you all agree, it's a new year, time for a new thing.
A new talk, you mean?
Is that so shocking, Fraulein Bowles?
The only shocking thing is that nobody can see that I've been trying, against all odds, to give the seedy little dive a little alert.
Alert? Our customers pay alert. Every time you leave a mob's the floor, they complain.
But darling, lots of people come here because of me.
No one will even notice you gone.
Max, I don't know about the laws here, but I mean, it can't be legal to just... Don't you have to give a gun to 2 weeks' notice, or at least a week?
Why don't you go organize a union, huh? Go join all those communists marching in the streets!
Max! Bastard! Come in.
I'm not sure I'm in the right place.
Oh. Chris!
Cliff.
Cliff. Did you come get a drink?
Sorry?
I promised to buy you a drink, didn't you? You are. Is gin alright? Yeah, of course it's all gone.
Gin? Why not?
But you pour, I've only got a few minutes. Why didn't you say you were English?
I don't know. A wing? You ever had a wing?
Oh, constantly. I used to love pretending I was someone else. Someone quite mysterious and fascinating. And someone I grew up and realized that I was mysterious and fascinating. And Sally Bowles. Happy New Year, darling! Are you new, Berlin?
I've only been here 3 hours.
3 hours? Welcome! How long are you staying?
I'm writing a novel. I'll stay till it's finished.
Oh, you're a novelist. How marvelous. You can learn about the fine people are and have a huge success and make lots of money.
Let's talk about Sally Bowles. What part of England are you from?
London. Stonehenge. Shrefford-on-Avon.
Oh, please. You mustn't ever ask me questions. If I want to tell you anything, I will. Why do you come to Berlin to do your novel?
I'd already tried London and Paris.
Just looking for a place to write?
Something. Write about.
Are you saying?
The Nollendorf Plots?
Oh, the Nollendorf Plots! I would love to live in a place like the Nollendorf Plots. So racy. I'll just go upstairs here. It'd be too divine to invite you up, but Max would be most terribly jealous.
Max? Your husband?
No, he's just a man of the living room. This week. I'm staying. Why shocking you talking this way?
I say, are you trying to shock me?
Oh, you're quite right, you know.
Daddy!
There's my cue. Is there really a place called Mario?
Absolutely. New Jersey.
Don't forget to leave your number.
That was never a good cover for you. Cliff, this is Victor. He's sharing my apartment.
Hello.
He knows all about you.
Oh, about you.
Anyways, I can't stay, but will you ring me?
Of course.
You better have.
Come, Bobby.
Yeah. Happy New Year. Come on, Cliff. This is Berlin. Relax. Loosen up. Be yourself.
You have to understand the way I am, my hair. Tiger is a tiger, a lamb I have. You'll never turn the vinegar, jam my hair. So I do, when I'm through to you. Mine, leave my hair, farewell my leave my hair. It was a fun affair, but now it's over. And now I used to care, I need the open day. You're better off without me, my hair. To give you all my hair, I wonder why my hair. I've ever said that time was over. You're right, you should have known by now. It's every cause to doubt in my hand. The continent of Europe is so wide, my hair. Not only up and down, but side to side, my hair. Couldn't you ever cross it? Try my hair. So I do what I can. Step by step, mile by mile.
marks.
60 marks?
It is not the money. 70. I cannot commit.
80.
85. And now, please, make yourself cozy, Frau Redshaw.
Such a to-do! I will see you Friday for our next lesson. But I am telling you something. I think I am taking from you the wrong kind of lessons.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Would you guess I was terrified?
Are you?
He threw me out! Can you imagine a battlefield being thrown out twice in one day?
You mean Max?
Dear Max, do you know whose fault it was, didn't you? If you hadn't come to the Kit Kat Club and been so dreadfully attracted, you signed this poetry
and forced your way into my dressing room.
Sally, about you. Staying here.
You know what I love, darling? Small gin.
Gin.
You got some?
No.
I think we must.
I don't have any gin.
Oh, well. Prairie oysters, then.
Prairie oysters?
I practically live on them. It's just raw egg whites and some Worcestershire sauce. It's hidden for a hangover.
I haven't got a hangover. Do you carry eggs around with you?
Of course. One never knows when one will have a desperate craving for an omelette. Don't worry. Actually, I sell it just from a Furby Stigs.
That's quite a coat.
It should be. It cost me all I had. Little did I know how soon I'd be unemployed.
I gather your friend Max runs the Kit Kat Club.
You're divinely intuitive. I do hope I'm not going to fall madly in love with you. Are you in the movie business in any way? And you're sick, more or less. Though I do believe a woman can't be a truly great actress until she's had several passionate affairs. And then a heartbroken. Oh, damn. I should let Ava pay my cab there. She's got all that money from Paris.
Paris?
She smuggled it in for some political party.
Ava's in politics?
Oh, it's also terrible, really. As you didn't know, she goes to Paris once a month and brings back pots of money.
But she has to smuggle it in?
You see, she's discovered that the customs people almost never open the bags of non-Germans. So just before the border, she finds an innocent-looking Englishman. Or an American.
It's hard to imagine an American that gullible.
Hold the blind, Rick! It means neg and neg, Rick. It's supposed to stop it happening, though I doubt it doesn't.
Tastes like peppermint.
It's because it's my toothbrush mug.
Well, it makes me feel terribly sensual.
Sally, you've got to understand.
Is that your novel? It's in German. Mein Kampf.
It's not my novel. I thought I should know something about German politics.
Mein Kampf. Oh, a typewriter! How creative. You could be the next Dostoevsky.
Right.
Comes on never would. Who? Gunther Warner. He just knows. And guess who's going to be next one? The woman in room 16.
And are you the woman?
No, unfortunately, I've been painting an English girl. It's a very good part. Gunther wrote it specifically for me.
What's it about?
Oh, the voice. Listen. Guten Tag. Und pin Kazir. Und die Gladerin.
Nobody's ever bothered to translate that for you.
Oh, but it's so much more fun than an image. Will you allow me to watch you while you write? Possibly incredibly quiet.
Look, I don't think I could work with someone else on the premises.
Now go out, kick it on, and invigorating walks.
In the middle of the night, there's another thing. I'm not a prude, at least.
Are you homosexual in any way? Bobby says you are.
Bobby?
One of the boys at the club. He says he met you in London. At a Nightingale bar?
The Nightingale bar?
Is it possible?
I guess anything's possible.
And did you and Bobby have an affair?
And did he say that?
He implied it.
Well, it's not the sort of thing you go around advertising, is it?
And isn't that sad? I think people are people, Cliff. I really do. Don't you? I don't think people should have to explain anything. For example, if I should paint my fingernails green, and it just happens that you're painting,
Well, if anyone should ask me what I say, I think it's pretty. I reply. So, if anyone should ask what you mean, too, you can either say, oh, yes, it's true. Well, I think it's delicious sin. Why, you can simply tell them the truth. And say, I met this perfectly marvelous girl in this perfectly wonderful place as I lift the glass to the start of a marvelous year. Before I knew what she called in the film, invite you. Next moment I was no longer his name, but served me. So I went to some perfectly beautiful verse in my charming American style. How I dazzled the senses was truly no less than a crime. Now I'm this perfectly marvelous girl in this perfectly beautiful room, and we're living together and having a marvelous time.
Sally, it just wouldn't work out. You're much too distracting.
Distracting? No! Inspiring! She tells me perfectly marvelous tales of her thrillingly scandalous life, which I'll probably use as a chapter or two of my book. And since my stay in Berlin was to force creation, what's luck to phone a fabulous song? The stimulation and perfectly marvelous too is her perfect agreement to be just as good as a traveler, giving my novel away. Now I'm this highly agreeable life in my perfectly beautiful room with my nearly invisible, perfectly marvelous girl.
Now that must be the taxi man.
You're not the taxi man.
Sally, I just can't afford. Do you have any money?
No, you must. Six?
Oh, God.
Please, Claire, just one day or two. Please.
I met this truly remarkable girl in this really incredible town, and she skillfully managed to talk her way into my room. I have a terrible feeling, I said a dumb thing. Besides, I've only got one narrow bed.
So you see, everybody in Berlin has a perfectly marvelous roommate. Some people have two people. Two ladies. And I'm the only man, yeah. I like it. This 2-for-1.
Two ladies.
Yeah.
I like it.
They like it. I go up daily to earn our daily bread, but we've one thing in common. She was me.
nothing beats the rings. I sleep in the middle. But there's a room on the bottom if you drop on some night. Two ladies. I'm the only man. Yeah. I like it.
That sailor out of my house.
This sailor, dear lady, it's my brother.
Out.
Wait. How dare you? You think it's easy finding a sailor? This is only my second since New Year's, and it's what? April,
your second.
Yeah,
your second.
Yeah.
Sure I must. You think I do not know what goes on in here? Sailors all the time, in, out. Hopefully not for the name of stick I'm running. A battleship. Run, I cost. I give you fair warning. One more sailor, I call the police.
And if I cannot pay the rent?
The rent is due each Friday, as always.
No sailors, no rent. I move.
Move?
Mom!
And what am I supposed to do with your room? Out of the room, she tells me, I move. Is this gratitude for you? Only last week I gave you another new mattress.
All right. So I end at the end of the week. Since you insist.
I insist? You insist!
So what about the sailors?
The sailors! Fraulein Kost, if you wish to continue living here, you must not let me catch you bringing in any more sailors, you understand?
Very good. So does the same as always?
No, it is not the same as always. Fräulein Kost, you hear me? I have put my foot down. Fräulein Kost! Fräulein Kost!
Fräulein Schneider. Oh, Herr Schultz, such a surprise. You are occupied?
No. Free as a bird. Please forgive my appearance.
Oh, this is most becoming.
Thank you.
Oh, I've brought you a little something. Comes a shop.
Another little something?
With my compliments.
So heavy. But what can it be?
Pears?
Last night's game brought me pears. And such pears. Apples, possibly?
Yeah.
Friday was apples.
Yeah, Friday was apples.
So I cannot guess.
Is it open?
Herr Schultz! Can I believe what I see? But this is too much to accept. So rare, so costly, so luxurious.
If you brought me diamonds, if you brought me pearls, if you brought me roses like some other gents might bring for other girls, it couldn't please me more than the gift I received. Come me.
young man presents to his lady love. It makes me blush.
Oh, but there is no one in all of Berlin would want to go there. If I could, I would fill your entire room with pineapples.
Pages. Are you all right, Sally?
Just not speaking today.
Okay. My mother says, tell Sally to lay off the gin.
She does not.
Here's the check.
Hooray! $50. How much is that for your money?
More than enough to pay the rent.
And dinner at the Adlon, with a bottle of champagne.
A glass of champagne?
All right. Why so gloomy?
Because we never have dinner at the Adlon anymore.
We never did. I'm so excited you finished your novel, Clifford, darling. What a liar I am.
Poor Clifford. My fault, really. Why my daddy's driving you off to party after party.
I love those parties. I like this whole town. It's so tawdry and terrible. Everyone's having such a great time. It's like a bunch of little kids playing in their room, getting wilder and wilder, knowing any minute their parents were about to come home.
Maybe you should write about your childhood.
It was my first novel.
Well, there must be something else to write about.
Sally Bowles.
I told you I'd inspire you. Lay a money, do Sally, but make me rushing, sublimely seductive. No man could resist me, not even a rather strange, handsome young American who allowed me to share his room and his bed and fall desperately in love with me. Don't worry, it's only fiction.
Now all I've got to do is write it.
You're so less distracting.
It's true. Nobody could work with you around. Not Hemingway, not Tolstoy, not even Proust. Sally, I didn't mean it.
But it's time. Viv, don't you think? I've never stayed with anyone so long. I must keep my bad muscle.
What's the matter? Had a better offer.
Nothing. I've never stayed with anyone so long. I'm sure you've always do.
Oh, dozens. A couple. Not one.
What about Bobby? He phoned today, by the way.
Don't go.
What?
Please, don't go.
Are you serious?
To hell with Bobby. Maybe I like you here. I need you. I need... The truth is, Sally, when you're out all night, I can't sleep. Our little bed suddenly seems so empty. I've never felt this way before about anyone. Anyone at all.
Do you truly mean this?
More than I've ever meant anything.
Oh, darling.
You want to tell me what's wrong?
Nothing. Not a thing. I'm pregnant.
Are you sure? Well, what are we going to do?
What am I going to do, you mean? The usual thing, I suppose.
You've done it before?
Thousands of times.
Don't you think you ought to check with father first?
Why?
Pay for the doctor, for one thing.
Oh, I do so hate to live that awful doctor.
Then maybe...
And anyway, maybe it's the father. It could be anyone.
It could be me. Sally, it could be me.
Andrew.
If it's mine.
Never know, will we?
We could.
Oh, yes. 9 months of being sick every morning, and then the happy Jay, and who's it resemble? Max, hard old German infant with a mustache, roaring us about!
I'm willing to take that chance.
Or a Malaysian. I seem to recall a rather tense Malaysian.
Shut up, Sally!
What?
Can we just be serious for 1 minute?
My dad is quick.
This could be the best thing that ever happened to us.
I doubt it. Could.
We're drifting. We've got no focus to our lives. A baby would make all the difference. I know it would to me. I'd get a job. I'd have to. I'd stay home nights, write the novel, wash the diapers. The whole bit. Sally, will you do this one thing for me, please? At least think about it before you see the doctor.
Something's bound to be in. must wish to intrude with your note. Would you like a drink, darling?
Only if you'll join me.
Just this once.
What's on your mind, Ava?
Oh, you remember, I mentioned the possibility of an occasional business trip to Paris. I think in the next 2 days if you are interested. If you do, you're going to be held to a very good course.
Don't tell me. Whatever it is, I don't want to know.
As you wish. Thank you.
How about going tomorrow?
Tomorrow? But we are going to the party.
I think I'll skip it.
Bye.
Let's just say, I'm turning over a new leaf.
New tree, I mean.
And Sally, you're turning over as well?
Who knows? Cliff and I just made that to be the two most utterly boring people you ever met!
So, for this business trip, all you will have to do is go to an address I will give you, and you'll pick up a small briefcase and bring it back to Berlin. And I will give you 75 marks.
75 marks?!
Yes, and that is only the beginning. So, you will go to Paris?
Absolutely. Anything for a buck. Prost!
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 So you see, there's more than one way to make money. Money makes the world go around, the world go around, the world go around. Money makes the world go around, it makes the world go round. A mark, a yen, a buck, or a pound, a buck, or a pound, a buck, or a pound is all that makes the world go around, that clinking, clanking sound can make the world go round.
Money, 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 money.
If you happen to be ripped to your feet like a knight to the king, on being
All right. There's no need to say it. I know it by heart already. So no lectures about sailors. They're just lonesome, patriotic German boys. I have a duty. Good night, Trudy. Make sure to come back very soon. Bring your friends next time. Go home. Good evening, Fraulein Schneider. A busy evening? No. I see, after all, we are sisters under the skin.
Fräulein Kost.
Yes.
This fine lady is not your sister. This fine lady has just consented to give me her hand in marriage.
Marriage?
Yes. We marry in 3 weeks.
3 weeks?
Yes. So a little respect for the future Frau Schultz.
Yeah, Frau Schultz.
Thank you, Herr Schultz. You were supreme. What else could I do? Such a magnificent lie to preserve my reputation.
Oh, but why did I say 3 weeks?
Why not 3 months? 3 years? This way she will find out the truth so quickly. Unless
what?
You send us.
Oh, but it's foolish.
I mean, after all, who would have an elderly widower bonding with heartburn and a little fruit?
Okay, my such body then? An unbeautiful spinster with some rooms for the poorly furnished.
I work 14 hours a day.
I do my own scrubbing.
All right, that bothers me.
I have such palpitations.
I am not a well man.
Am I a well woman?
What are we talking about? We're alive, and what good is it alone?
So, if you would consider marriage,
I will consider it.
But by all means, no hurry.
We should discuss it, but we must not marry merely to humiliate Fräulein Kost.
I assure you, Fräulein Schneider, this is not the case.
But let us be honest. Had she not seen us, she would not have proposed today.
Then tomorrow.
You mean this?
I had it in my mind.
It is all so impulsive.
Oh, you hesitate because you have never been married. It frightens you.
Believe me,
it can work wonders.
I'm afraid.
I always forget.
Of course you do. You're not mortally ill every morning.
Neither are you.
Yeah, that's the time. Come, I can't wait to give you the presents. Let me put your back.
Herr Schultz?
Fräulein Schneider. Herr Schultz, this is for you. Let me get it. Herr Schultz, crystal. Come, crystal. It's for fruit. Beautiful. I promise you, I promise you, little sister, will not be empty. Fräulein Schneider. And my welcome? Ah, Fraulein Kost, forgive me. I did not invite you, but only because I know work in the evenings. Well, tonight I am free.
Oh, I should live so long.
Rosie, this is Fraulein Schneider. It's her party. You must dance with her.
I did not pass so long.
Sally, Ava, do you have some great kids?
Oh, Paris perfume, silk stocking.
75 marks and you found them! And now I should let you go find our friend. Yes, we
have to. Do I have to?
Yes. I wish you much happiness.
Oh, thank you, Frank.
I am sorry to be late, but there was a meeting and it was a meeting.
Oh, what love of our master.
And now I should like to leave the room with me.
Where can he be? He's been having a blessed schnapps with everybody, so he will forgive him easily.
Good evening, good evening.
Come and drink with me.
Yes, this
Rosie, my old friend.
Rosie, speak Herr Schultz.
Good evening, Rosie.
If you have a drink with me, a table of eaters is so much food.
There's so many
fine young men. I will introduce you to them, except I do not know their names.
Just introduce yourself.
You will dance. Would you like another shot? I suppose. You did not give me the first one yet.
No.
I will do it.
Oh, you have had enough!
You hear? You hear? Not even married yet, and already she is in charge. And it is pleasant. It's nice to have someone tell me that I've been foolish.
Many, many happy years and a standing couple.
Beautiful dancing. Remember me? Roland Fox? Must dance with me? Come, come.
Clifford, Peter. Do you want my briefcase? And Scott?
Oh, I'm sorry. Since you did not wish to know my politics.
Is this the good cause?
Our party believes the builders of the new Germany.
Yes. I've been reading your Peter's book.
What does it matter? We are friends, close friends. With your permission. I can invite the party. Herr Schultz is the most generous host, yeah?
He should be. He can afford that one as much. They have all the money. The Jews.
Herr Schultz? I think I have changed my mind. If you'll excuse me, Fraulein. Fraulein Schneider, I must speak with you. It is a matter of much importance. Think of what you are doing. This marriage, it is not advisable for your own welfare.
What about Herr Schultz's welfare?
He is not a German.
He was born here.
He is not
a German.
Good night. Sorry, Clifford. Good night.
Oh, but it is just beginning. Come, we will make it amusing, you and I, yeah? Ladies, gentlemen, wait. Frau Ludwig, this is for you.
Sun on summer door with summery warm. So step it up for its front free. But gather to greet the storm. Tomorrow belongs to me. The branch of the lenden is leafy and green. The Rhine gives its gold to the sea. But somewhere a glory awaits, unseen. Tomorrow belongs to me. Brothers, sing with me. The babe in its cradle is closing its eyes. The blossom embraces the bees. But so says a whisper, arise, arise, tomorrow belongs to me evermore.
Children have waited to see the morning when comes alone is mine. Tomorrow belongs to our father and mother and show us a sign. Your children have waited to see. The morning when comes the world is mine. Tomorrow belongs to me.
Thank you.
refreshments. Blue apples, fresh off a tree. Delicious, please.
Perhaps later.
About the party last evening. I do not remember it too well. You said that to me, really. You ever forgive me?
For what? A few glasses of schnapps?
I promise. No more drinking. You will be very proud of me.
I am already proud of you. But as far as the wedding is concerned, there is a problem. A new problem.
A new problem?
New to me because I had not thought about it before, but at the party last night, my eyes were opened. And I saw that one can no longer dismiss the Nazis. They are my friends and my neighbors. How many others are there?
Of course, many. And many are socialists. But come here. Come here. Come here.
The Nazis come to power.
We'll be married to a Jew.
But also a German.
German, as much as anyone.
I need a license to rent my rooms. If they take that away,
they will take nothing away. From Fräulein Schneider, I don't want to go to the lowest apple on the tree. I want the easiest to reach. Come up a little way. The apples are so much more delicious. If I fall, we'll catch you, I promise. I feel such tenderness for you. It is difficult to express. I'm too old for it right now. Far too old.
I'm no Juliet. You are no Romeo. We must be sensible.
And never alone? How many meals have you eaten alone? 1,000? 5,000? 20,000. You be sensible. Governments come. Governments go.
Orange. Oh, I will
do it.
It is nothing! The children are to wait for so mischievous fortune and nothing more, I assure you!
You wonder why I chose her, yeah? Out of all the ladies in the world, that's just the first impression, yeah? What good's the first impression? If you knew her like I do, it would change your point of view. If you could see her through my eyes, you wouldn't wonder at all. If you could see her through my eyes, I guarantee you would fall like I did. Yet when we're walking together, I do society wrong. But if they could see her through my eyes, well, maybe they'd leave us alone. I might even have a baby. A banana. How can I speak of her virtues? I don't know where to begin. She's clever, she's smart, she reads music, yeah? She doesn't smoke or drink gin, like I do. Yes, but we're walking together. I hear society more. But if they could see her through my eyes, well, maybe they'd leave us alone.
Very good.
Mesdames, mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, please.
Hello.
Why can't the world? Labor, all we are asking is for a little understanding. Yeah? I can't live and let live. I understand your objection. I grant you the problem's not small. But if you could see them through my eyes, well, you wouldn't look Jewish at all. Cut my evening back inside.
Did you get a job?
Try again tomorrow.
There is no fear. Yes, you were summoned back to the Kit Kat Club today. Ta-da! It turns out they want me back desperately.
Why?
Because they finally realized how valuable I am. Bobby and Victor tell me it's been dead since I left, so it's not tonight. It's not happening.
You sweat.
Because of the money, you need it so badly.
Not that badly.
I don't understand you. Really, I don't. First, you tell me you're not going to Paris for Ava anymore. Even though it seems like the very easiest way in the world to make money.
Or the hardest. You know, Sally, someday I've got to sit you down and read you a newspaper. You'd be amazed at what's going on.
Holidays? What has that to do with us?
Right. Nothing. Anything to do with us. Sally, don't you understand? You're not against all of this. You're for it. You might as well.
Come in. Come on, Schneider.
I just...
No, no, come in. Is that your football? Is something wrong with it?
I cannot keep it.
Why?
I'm engaged at present, but there is no engagement.
What do you mean?
We have reconsidered, Patience and I.
Fräulein Schneider, you can't give up that way.
Oh, yes, I can. That is easy to say. Easy for you. Fight, and if you fail, what does it matter? You pack your belongings, move to Paris. And if you do not like Paris, where? That is easy for you. What if you and me, with time rushing by, what would you do with the clock running down? What would you do? The young always have the cure, being brave, being sure and free. But imagine if you were alone like me, this is the only world I know. Sorrows to let the sum of a lifetime, even so, I'll take your advice. What would you do? Would you pay the price? What would you do? Suppose simply keeping still means you manage to tell the end. What would you do, my brave young friend? Grown old like me, with neither the will nor wish to run, grown tired like me, who worries for men when day is done, grown wise like me, who isn't at war with anyone.
He's so aggressive.
What would you do? Suppose your unfrightened voice be told what the choice must be. Go on, tell me. I will listen. What would you do if you were
If you marry Herr Schultz, whatever problems come up, you'll still have each other.
All my life, I have managed for myself, and it is too old a habit to change. I have battled alone, and I survived. There was a war, and I survived. There was a revolution, and I survived. There was an inflation, billions of marks for a single loaf of bread, but I survived. And if the Nazis come, I will survive. And if the communists come, I will still be here, renting these rooms. But in the end, what other choice have I? This is my world. I regret very much returning. It is truly wrong. I regret everything.
What would you say?
Is nothing at all. Or can sell her. Remember how she was about me staying here.
It is not possible. I cannot consider.
Shut up,
Sally. Still, they're trapping.
What? It's not funny. Well,
she's nothing to need to do about
it. What's such fun? Today with Bobby. Yeah, that's a different thing. Especially the fact that you and me are caught into the end of the lane with our backs going. Waiting for this very end. Where's my number, so I really must go.
That is. You're going on further than to love.
Yeah.
We're going home. My home. And it's clean.
You're joking.
I'm going to sell this. Get us as far as Paris. I'll cable home. Speech is fair.
What are you talking about?
We've got to leave Berlin as soon as possible tomorrow.
But we love it here.
Sally, wake up. The party's over. It's lots of fun, but now it's over. So how could we live here? How could we raise a family?
But is America the answer? Running away to America!
We're not running away. We're going home.
I'm certain. That's fine for you. Oh, for me. My career.
You've got a new career.
But I can work at the club for several months at least in November. I want the world, Bobby. All the most elegant, expensive things.
We'll talk about it tomorrow. On.
We can't just uproot our life that quickly!
Oh no! You give me 1 hour. Sit down! Or better yet, start packing. There's plenty to do. Call the club. Tell them goodbye.
Oh, I call it.
when there's bread to me. So have you kissed me? If we touch, warning's fair. I don't care very much. I don't care much. Go! Or stay. I'll get a job.
The stone worker.
I'll find something.
Maybe. But this is sure.
This? What the hell is this? You keep talking about this as if it ever really existed. When are you going to admit, Sally, that the only way you got this job, any job, is by fucking someone?
Will you shut up, Glenn?
All this talk about your career, my God. For once in your life, face the truth about yourself.
But now don't you think it's your turn?
Stop.
Clifford, will you join me for a drink?
Not now.
I have been trying to reach you at Fraulein Schneider's. I have another urgent errand for you. This time I pay 150 marks.
The answer is no.
What is wrong, Clifford? You are angry with me?
I am.
It's because of politics. If you were a German, you would understand these things.
Goodbye, Geneva.
Wait. This errand, it is most important. I pay 200 marks.
Go to hell.
This is most upsetting. I have sent you many new students.
Oh, sure. Your Nazi friends to polish up their English. What an idiot I've been.
I know you need the money. So there must be something else. It is because of that Jew at the party.
Meine Damen und Herren, Mesdames und Messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, please. Kit Kat Club is proud to welcome back old friends. I give you the toast of Mayfair, Fräulein Sally Bowels!
Come to the cabaret.
cabaret, oh chum. Come to the cabaret.
I used to have a girlfriend known as Elsie. You must share four sordid rooms in Chelsea. She was the one who called a flower. As a matter of fact, she rented by the hour. The day she died, her neighbours came to stick her. Letter comes in too much pills and liquor. But when I saw her, they had like a queen. She was the happiest girl I'd ever seen. Have seen to his very days.
I remember.
Forget what I said at the club last night. Forget you can't even me. staying out all night. So cold.
What am I love, darling?
First thing in the morning. How about a prairie oyster?
No, Jim.
Can't be good for expected mothers. Where's your coat? The fur coat? Leave it at the club.
Was
it last night? That way you did come home.
Oh, darling. That's such a name. Yeah. My mom. I honestly believe you have been a wonderful father. Perhaps that greedy doctor. I'm going to miss my fur coat. It always ends this way. Even my dear, fine. And it's worth it. It's just not enough. That's for it. You would. My wife's the most exciting thing.
That's not true. I never have run away from you for any reason. Not if there was a baby.
To hold us together, you mean? What a terrible burden for an infant, don't you think?
It's time for the train. Sally, I could go tomorrow or the next day. Here's your ticket. Parents. If for any reason you decide to use it, I'll be at the American Express office until Friday. You can reach me there.
I'd always rather lay in the grass.
Oh, Sally.
No. Dedicate your book to me.
Deutsche Grenzkontrolle, Ihre Pässe. I hope you haven't stayed your stay. Yeah? Very much, sir. And that you will come again very soon.
Not very likely.
You did not find our country beautiful?
Yes. I found it beautiful.
Very good. Deutsche Grenzkontrolle, in passe, bitte.
There was a cabaret. There was a master of ceremonies. There was a city called Berlin. And a country called Germany. It was the end of the world. And I was dancing, Sally Bowles, and we were both fast asleep. Bienvenue, bienvenue, welcome. Frater, étranger, stranger. Nous glissons sur la piste de sweet enchanté. To see you, bleibe, let's stay. Willkommen, bienvenue.
cabaret, to cabaret. Meine Damen und Herren, Mesdames et Messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, we have no troubles now. Pardon? I told you so. We have no troubles here. Here, life is beautiful. The birds are beautiful, yeah? Even the orchestra is beautiful! Really well. I really appreciate everybody in this room and outside of this room and all around. Thank you so, so much.
He's was on Tuesday, I believe, and I cried. I was like,
oh, man.
And also, all three nights, I have cried over, I don't care much. It's like, I cried over.
Well, I hope they know the ending meme.
Yeah, see, during the first night, people didn't get it, so they added
all did such a great job.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
I hope
and I'm sorry for our kids. Yeah. Yeah.
So excited.
Thank you. Yeah.
No, the fucker's in school.
Shit.
Was it really recorded?
It's a live feed.
For where? For what?
I don't know, but I think it's Instagram or Facebook. It's Facebook.
Only like two people are watching.
I know, one person.
Damn, that was so good. I kind of want to look at the wiki just like follow along.
Fair enough.
Because I kind of wish like get like a phone number.
Sorry, you asked for one. Yeah, yeah. We had, like, for, I was in Wisconsin on that podcast.
Oh, yeah.
And we couldn't get it in the script, so he gave us scripts. So we had extra scripts. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I didn't know to ask.
I thought of that while I was in the back room, but I knew that they wouldn't have the extra ones in the back room.
Yeah, so just look. I'm talking to the camera, not you.
Oh, okay.
So, you know. Thank you all for coming and watching.
Yeah, so I was like,
yeah.